everybody, welcome to another exciting episode of the RPG Makers. As you can see, we have prepared for you a burning pumpkin bulletin board of information for today's episode. The Pirate Cove, as you saw in the time lapse, I guess people were like, it's really a speed up, Jesse. You're so dumb.
What I like more is the people raging about the end song in that mix that was dubstep. It was hilarious.
Yeah, sure, hilarious.
And then so that is prepared. We're ready to start building there. The desert has been terraformed, but details are needed. Library decorations have progressed to where I don't know. We have work on the temple behind us that is less penis-y now.
Oh my god!
And ideas for the obsidian wall. We need to go back to that. And of course, Lewis set his desk on fire. How'd that go, buddy?
I'm not going to talk about that. I've found something even better. This story is going to be great.
What?
I was literally just sitting here right now. I've got a bag of rhubarb and custard boiled sweets here.
I'm sorry, what the hell? What the hell is that? What? Rhubarb and custard boiled sweets? Only in
rhubarb
England would that be a thing.
Well, jam a fork in it. And it's basically, it's this like two-flavored sweet. And I was thinking to myself, how great would it be if there was an entire rhubarb and custard? And I look at my bag of board sweets and there was one. I'm so happy right now.
What an amazing story.
I'm going to take a picture of this and I'm going to put it on the internet.
I need to know. I need to know the fire story. See, you're leaving me. All right. You're leaving me hanging. You're leaving me hanging right now, and it's because of the fact that there's a fire story. This is just like Thomas's Asian hooker story. I still don't know what happened. I'm still waiting for answers. No one's telling me anything. I need to know, and I need to know fire story.
Asian hooker story.
Okay. It's not how Kisuke's making it out to be, like there was a great blaze or anything.
Fire London.
I came in from work, tripped over a cable that was on my floor, slammed into the base of my desk, which then cracked. My entire desk leaned to one side and everything slid down it, my monitors, everything. And I had, being me, a 2-liter bottle of Dr. Pepper open on said desk, which again slid down over a plug socket. I also had a kind of deodorant, which then got crushed on the desk. resulting in me having to get a new desk from IKEA yesterday, which set me back about £120.
That is beautiful.
I thought that was going to get better. Like, you were going to say the Dr. Pepper landed on the plug, which sparked, and then the deodorant set it on fire.
Well, that's Didn't I make that clear?
Yeah. I'm pretty sure he set up everything that he had some type of bomb situation going on there. I'm pretty sure that's how he set it up. Like, a makeshift bomb was created when his desk collapsed.
Daxon's trying to kill me.
All right. Well, that's good. I guess that makes up for the fact that I still don't know what happened to Thomas. Thomas is at work right now.
Thomas's story is great.
I know Thomas's story.
I still don't know the story.
Me neither.
You better get home soon. Thomas! I want to hear the Asian hooker story so bad. This top part of this dome... This is done, yes? So the outside of this building is finished, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're just going to ruin, like...
The pretty part
corner
on the top.
Of it.
Need to poke holes in it.
So it doesn't look like it's absolutely perfect. So crumble it a bit at the top. Add a couple of vines.
Yeah, so our next step here is to finish up the hourglass in the library. Did we manage to get that working?
No, not yet. We need to wait for the thing that Kisuke needs to do the plug-in that's going to go with it.
And what is that exactly?
It needs events or something. Kisuke!
Kisuke, talk to us!
Tell me our secret, Gypsy.
Gypsy? Should be complicated.
Not getting done anytime soon. Great. Okay.
Is it redstone?
Why is that? Why isn't it getting done anytime soon?
Because... Basically, he needs what's known as the mod API, I'm assuming. Yes.
Oh, so is that coming in the next one?
Blink
in the next
twice.
Patch?
No, it's coming in the next one.
Oh,
my
ground right.
scripting
so that's
system.
The next patch?
So it's basically we're just waiting for them to release the mod API and then it'll be piece-piss. By piece-piss, I mean I'll just get Kisuke to do it.
Alright, but...
Decoration-wise, in said library, where are you? Where's Jesse?
I'm looking around.
Okay.
What is...
People have been working.
Oh, okay. I was like, what
people
is
have
this
been
thing connected?
Well, all that. People have been working on this, just adding some details during the
people.
Week.
People. Sure.
I don't know. Nadine, probably. I don't know if Kiske was here at some point. We kind of hit a snag, though. We realized we didn't include a stair on the second level. So currently, we have the ground floor, which is a maze.
There.
First floor, second floor, but there's no way to get to the
third floor. All right, like, well, that's an easy fix.
Suggestions?
You just remove the bookcases at the sides here and put another set of stairs in.
Do it on the back over here. Yeah, back
but
here.
There's...
The thing is, though, I said that to you. This level is where the incline becomes inwards again, so the walls become one block in every time. So if you do a stair on this level here...
Well, why can't you do a stair behind it? Like, do a stair in the wall back here that goes up around it. So, like, just take out these rows here and then build into the wall back here. Like, boop, boop. Go
to bring it out of the sides of the,
and then it will go up in the back. Yeah. And that way, that's the first thing you see, so you know that it's important. So are we going to do a double entrance then?
Yeah, come see how I punch the bookcase through upstairs.
I see. I'm looking at it right now.
Ah.
Yeah. Oh, I saw it! You know what? I think Kiske should have the voice of the Candy King. Hello there, everybody! What are you doing? That's Kiske's voice. Kiske, say something.
Great impression, Kiske.
Also, Jesse! The teacher and your fan Friday sounded like Ultros! It also sounds like you now.
Lol.
Kiske is Ultros.
What are you guys doing?
I don't know what Ultros is.
Ultros is the greatest Final Fantasy character ever. He is
a big purple octopus.
Yes, Ultros is my favorite character because, one, he's a bad guy who, like, is a horrible person, but no one takes seriously because he's an octopus with with the derpy eyes and a smile. And he's like, I'll get you! And he, like, runs after people. And he's basically, like, a hentai character in a Final Fantasy game. He serves no purpose. He, like, whacks people with his tentacles and is like, ouch, kids! Don't pet the octopus! He has, like, really bad ones. It's amazing. He's an amazingly bad character. It's halfway through the game, your major boss fights are him. It's like, wait, this isn't even a guy. It's an octopus at an opera house. That doesn't make any sense. I'm a purveyor of the fine arts. What are you saying? Okay, the stairs. Are we going to make one set of stairs crumbled? Is that what's happening here?
I think we've just got to make them the same now.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, we could make one crumbled or one like
fuck you.
One's caved in or something.
Fuck you.
No, too late for that. The woman's got it in her mind. The woman's got it in her mind, Lewis. You can't get it out the mind. You can't get it out her mind brain hole. Just ain't gonna happen.
Mind brain
don't associate Nadine.
Mind brain hole.
What?
Mind what brains. Happening? Mind brain hole. That's where your thought ideas come from.
Biology by Jesse.
All right, so what do we have left, Lewis? We have right now. This place is basically done, yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Well,
so
I want to point out that all the credit for this goes to everybody but me.
Oh, don't worry. We know. We're aware.
What did you say?
Nothing.
You say
what? It's self-evident.
Put silence.
We don't need to. We don't need to say anything. It's self-evident. Okay, Kiske, come over here. And Lewis, I guess, if you'd be so kind. This, you know, your exit is in another castle is cute, but just for future record, so everyone remembers, we're going to make just like a long tunnel here, and it'll just go deep, 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 and then at some point, you'll just get teleported out, and it'll be like, you've traveled far, but you're now outside, so we can save people the trouble and save world space. And that should, perfect. So then it'll just go a distance, and then At some point here while you're running through it, it'll be like, boop, boop, teleport. All right, cool. We'll detail that hallway later and make it into something. But for now, I think our next step, our next big project is Pirate's Cove. I'm very excited about this.
Mm-hmm.
Very excited. Let's do this.
Me too.
So for all of you who saw the time-lapse or speed-up video, this is that area, Pirate's Cove. This is going to be the main base of the Sky Pirates. And I think we're kind of borrowing the idea of that pirate base at the end, middle endish of the third Pirates of the Caribbean movie. That's like boats built up on top of each other. But in this case, the idea that I thought would be clever is if it's boats, but then it, yeah, Shipwreck Cove. Thank you. This one, it's boats, but then they progressively get from normal boats to like more advanced to then like skyships to then at the top is like an actual port where all the skyships meet. I thought that'd be kind of a nice, fancy, cool thing.
Boats everywhere.
That's the bottom is just rafts. The bottom is just 1,000 little rafts. That's it. How does this place support itself?
Doesn't it just drift randomly from shoreline to shoreline in the cove? Mm-hmm. That's why they built it here to contain it.
Can we steal some of those boats that we had? Remember how we had those ships? Is that server?
No, moment,
still,
no.
We still have access to that?
Ooh.
Ah, the boats! Exactly.
Ah, shit.
Okay.
With the horrific crystal.
The random dragon skull.
I
wonder what it was.
What we need is like.
Free dragon skull.
We need to take, like, for example, this boat right here. This boat.
Yeah.
And then let's, like, this boat that. Basically, all the airship boats. We take them, but without the airship part. Not the ones that have the crystal in it. The ones that are, like, actual air.
Okay.
Yeah. And we take those, and we get all of it except for the. Airship part, the like balloon part, and then we use them to build the base. So we can get rid of all the sails and all those different things, and that will be the base of what we create. I like the little curlicue at the end here. It's very creative. Like, oh, welcome to Pink Beard's pirate ship.
Fabulous.
So we have 3 ships, yes?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Yep. I need to figure out how we're going to order these. I definitely think one should be crashed into another. And that's like sort of what starts it. And then.
I think.
Yeah? What do you think? What do you think, buddy?
Oh, sorry. No, I didn't mean to interrupt. Go.
No, please.
He just
please,
actually failed.
Please.
God damn it. God damn it.
He was just like, I think. That's it. That's all I was had to say. I think. Good for you. Who wants a Happy Meal? Who wants a Happy Meal? You do. Let's add another ship. And balls. How are we supposed to complete this? Mewis is dying.
Apologies. I will stop dying.
Don't please die on me, soldier! Do we have any other big ships that look sort of different from this? From these?
What about one in the old
The ones
code?
In the tutorial.
The tutorial one, those are the future ships, though. Those are the ones that are going to be super special specifically to Vector. So these are the old,
right.
Like, the old ships of old, from days of yore.
The oldie ships?
The E is for extremely important. Like, we need another ship, like, here in the back part of this one, and then stick 2 other ships over here doing the exact same thing. Like, they scuttled all 5 ships together and made the base of this fort city.
I like that word.
What word?
Scuttled?
Scuttled.
I do. It is a wonderful nautical term.
Kiske, do...
Like this, like Curly Q ship we can add. That can go next to this big one over here. That means we need 2 other ships, though.
Kiski, do go to Archive World and go to the original Pirate Mountain base thing. There should be a couple of very, very, very defaulty airships we can strip down.
Defaulty airships, strip them down. That's what we do.
That song.
When Mary
this time on RPG
to
Maker, stripping.
Yes.
Stripping down, Nadine.
Oh, stripping down.
Stripping down. I know, I know, I know you wanted to, but I'm gonna have to break your heart.
Aww.
Who's heart?
Don't go breaking my heart! Alright, so after a lot of hard work on Lewis and Kiske's part, we are back with what appears to be the base of our structure here. I assume there's... Oh. Okay, great. Lewis could have spoken up to correct me, but he didn't. So that's his. It's his own fault.
What?
Exactly.
Not even listening.
Exactly. So what we need to do now is, well, two things. One, we need to add little ships around the outside. Those are like little people's homes. Not little people, but the
people's little homes.
Hobbits.
Thank you. Hobbit homes.
Hobbit. Yeah.
And then we also need to make it look like these are not just. make it look like these are not connected, but actually, like you can move between the different boats, so they're all connected on the inside as well.
What we'll do is the next thing we'll do is we'll probably go into each of the boats, hollow it out, and actually remake it so that you can do that. Because currently they're just like pasted on top of each other.
Okay, and then I just had an idea. I like this pagoda so much that I want to keep it. Is it possible to build around this structure as we go up? So this is like an open courtyard area, and then people are paying homage to the old gods of whatever can like come here and walk up to it and use that path right there. But everything else around it, all the structures make it look like a courtyard in the middle as we go up. So even as we're higher and there are airships, you can still look down and see that thing.
Yeah.
Cool. Excellent. Excellent!
All we'll need to do is we'll need to make some sort of dock on one of these like larger outer ships. But then, yeah, we can still keep this exposed so everything's centered around it.
Should we create a skeleton of how we want it to look when it's done? Like an outline of how far we're going to go up? So, because I assume what's going to happen next is we're going to have to find ships. Like multitudes of different ships to sort of stack up on each other.
You're trying to swallow rhubarb and custard.
Fucking yeah, stop teleporting me around! Fuck you!
Lewis is dying, Maywest! Lewis is dying!
God damn it! What's going on?
It's Giske's command block. He's put a command in there, put a clock on it, it comes just,
oh,
teleport.
Jesus Christ.
Don't
rhubarb,
headbutt your
you
desk again and fall over and knock a
ah,
shit.
Shut up.
No! Giske, fuck off.
Yes.
Oh,
fuck
that
off.
Was painful. Anyway.
Now I like what you guys did with the wall here. This is an improvement. The layered part is an improvement. I like that. It's much taller, much more ominous than it was before. Plus the red isn't like all in your face like, I'm red, bitch! What you gonna know about that? It's now just like there. It's subtle.
Like I'm red, but it's okay because I'm red.
Yeah, I'm okay with being red.
So
you should be okay with
this?
It too.
Like more
I can sound like someone's
gay. We'll buy you a nice dinner and we're going to hug afterwards.
Well, I feel like we need to somehow incorporate the giant nails into the wall somehow. And I don't know if that should be in place of that tower thing that's built there.
Could
yeah.
be.
I from ground level, it looks amazing. Like, it looks great. And to have that stretch the entire length of this continent would be ballsy-wallsy. Okay, aww. So, where's Thomas? Aww. Where's Thomas?
He's still AFK.
Thomas is a giant turd bucket.
Look, Thomas needs to be here. Thomas needs to tell me the story about that hooker! I need to know! What is going on with this hammer into this thing? How are we going to make this work? Is this tower
well,
going to be on there?
We can make another section of this, like a flat section, and then paste this in and see what it looks like.
Yeah, I feel... Because here's what I'm thinking. I feel like this tower right here, it almost seems like we might not need it at all. I mean, I guess maybe one or two. I don't know why we would. Instead, just have the nails be driven into them. So it looks like a wall was built, or this giant slab of metal was put down, and then it was sort of hammered in. And that way, people are like, whoa, what happened here? And then we can make up lore for it later. Trust me, baby.
Oh, he can call you baby. Okay, I see how it is.
What? He knows. he knows where his bread is buttered. Mm.
Hey.
Mm. Say what now?
Bread. Not okay with this?
Bread is buttered.
Oh, my.
Is this where we're going to do the cutoff here, then?
Yeah, around here.
So the desert needs to cut, like, the wall needs to cut off where this desert water meet, but it needs to go a great deal out into the water, or we need to set up, like, an invisible wall or something where people can't get past. Because knowing the internet, the first thing people want to do is get past it.
We can do what we did on the other area over there. We can just mount in this section up.
I guess that makes sense. I mean, it looks like it's already sort of mounted, so...
Yeah, but that's mountaining and did that they can climb.
Yeah, but, you know. I have no clue.
Why would they want to go into the ocean?
We should just stick Ender Dragons in here and be like, oh, yeah, sure, come on in.
Ender Dragon don't give no dang.
Ender Dragon don't care. Ender Dragon got mouths to feed. All right, so let's put these nails down, finally.
All right, it's ready.
We need to rotate it, don't we?
No, it's fine. Good.
Yeah, it's good the way it is. We just need to move it and put it.
It's only got a 2-block center on the side. It needs a 2-block center on every side.
No, it's good. It's good. Crack-a-lacka, let it go.
Doesn't need it on the north to south side. That's fine. It can be odd that way.
Just place it. Just place it.
No one's going to notice.
Just place it. Just place it. Just place it. Just place it.
Place the damn nail, damn it.
Just place the nail.
For a minute then, I thought it was Thomas, and I was about to flip shit.
Just nail it.
What are you guys talking about?
I know, just another show comes on.
What are you doing? It's me, Thomas!
I was watching how to make the pickle daring.
I watch how to eat shark balls. It tastes good. I bet that's a show. How to Eat the Shark Balls by the King of Norway. Greetings, Norway subjects. My name is King Kjørgen, and today I teach you how to eat the shark balls. Step one. Go to the water and dip your feet in. The shark will be attracted by the strong scent of your hobbit legs. I assume there are hobbits in Norway. Step number two. What you do now is you reach out and grab the shark by the balls. Step three, you eat the balls. This has been... the King of Norway, teaching you how to eat the balls.
Thomas is here, Jesse.
I see.
Yay, hooker story.
Thomas.
Maybe I am.
Thomas. Thomas.
It is.
Hi.
Yeah.
Thomas. Oh. Thomas.
Lewis, Jesse.
Thanks, buddy. It's Thomas, I have a question. I need an answer. For weeks, I've been hearing about the amazing story with you and an Asian prostitute. And I need to know what happened with the Asian prostitute. You have to tell me.
Well, in Thailand, right, there's this, in the main street, it's called a soi. They have these streets that are, like, different things in them.
I'm sorry, what? They have what?
Different, like, one is a restaurant. Roads. It's like a road with different stuff for them, right?
Yeah, okay,
so
there's
one of them is called Cowboy Street, and that's basically where the strip clubs and the hookers are.
Cowboy they Street, okay.
Cowboy Street. Or everyone's in one area. So me, my dad, and a friend of my dad went to check out Cowboy Street.
Did you now? Go on!
And then... We got some guy told us earlier that you just go straight through it. You just look straight forward, or else you're going to be dragged into some fucking strip club and, like, get a blowjob for $5 or whatever. So,
I like how some guy's advising you not to do that. Like, look, You do not want to get a blowjob. Those are the worst, sir. They so might. Just keep going. Keep, do, not, do not look at the well, Asian so, whores.
All teeth. All
so
teeth.
We go oh, through, God. And then my dad's friend, he walks off, and he looks in there. And it's just a bunch of naked ladies in there. And then suddenly this hooker comes up to me, takes my arm, and yells, "Happy hour, happy hour!" Tries to drag me into this fucking strip club. And I'm like, no, thank you. I don't want happy hour. And she, like, she doesn't let me go. So she drags me halfway over there before I, like, wrestle my way out. And I almost ran out of the fucking street. And that's the story of hookers trying to kidnap me.
No, no hooker kidnapped. What? I was led to believe that a hooker kidnapped you.
Well, she tried, but I'm not a small man. It's not like some Thailand hooker's gonna carry me off into the strip club.
But she wasn't gonna kidnap you. I thought a woman had kidnapped you and was like gonna ransom
no,
you off.
No, she wanted me to get happy hour.
Happy hour, happy and hour.
I didn't want happy hour.
What the fuck?
We need a fan art of Thomas being carried away into the sunset by an Asian hooker.
She was pretty tall.
What we need is. The Cookie Monster oh God, being carried away by an Asian hooker.
Thomas is an Asian woman. Jesus Christ.
Amazon woman.
So what else did you do there? I'm interested in your trip to Thailand.
We went around in Thailand.
Yeah, yeah okay. Like, so what happened? Like, the, that's all you did on Cowboy Street?
And everything. Yeah,
We were about to what?
No, we went in and looked and like all the naked ladies and yeah.
Was that a bonding experience for you and your dad and your dad's friend? You're like, yes, yep, those are Asian hookers. Good work, son.
Just, well, I didn't want to go there because
father
I was
is the last person
whoa.
Because why do with my father and like it, I don't feel it's appropriate to get to strip.
Don't worry, neither do I. Father. That's why I'm asking you about it because I think it's hilarious. nothing says bonding time with your father like, "Hey, let's go look at naked Asians." Okay, so what else did you do there? There's so much story here. There's so much life.
Well, first off, in Thailand everything's dirty cheap, like nothing costs anything.
Okay, so did you live like
so we rented this Asian guy with Thailand dude.
Whoa! You rented a man?
We rented him in his boat for one day and he like drove us wherever we wanted to do.
Can
the
I ask you how much that cost?
Snorkeling. Like I think we paid $200 or something.
For a whole day of some guy taking you around?
Yep.
That's not bad.
He gave us ananas. Is that what you call it in English? Pineapple. That's what you call it.
He gave you a reward for paying me. It's pineapple.
And all along the fucking beach are these massage studios. Or massage wherever, like just a tent and then they massage you. And it's like wherever you fucking go, you get these Asian women just dragging you everywhere and like, "Massage, you wanted the massage, cheap massage, it's good for you."
Oh, it sound like that.
All the way down there, yeah? None of them speak English and they want you to have a massage. And it's cheap and it's good for you. And you get
the
pineapple
irony.
And cookies and all over the fucking place.
And
then
we
like the first day on the beach, we got dragged in by this Asian woman, and she all like dragged. We were 10 people, and she took us all to her massage thing. And every time
she
we were
massaged
on
the, all the, 10 of you at the same time, like massage.
every time we were on that fucking beach, the same woman like comes and gets us and drags us off to the fucking place. And then my brother gets bit by a monkey and has to get a rabies shot. So they drive my brother to the fucking like
whoa. Why did you lead with the hooker story when your brother getting bit by a monkey is 10 times better? Oh
like,
my god.
He was like, there was monkeys on the one end of the beach, and they were like batshit fucking crazy. And like,
so your brother was like, "I'm gonna go hang with the monkeys?"
Yeah, well, they were so cute. So we went to the monkeys.
You just said they were batshit crazy.
Yeah, they were. Like, if you touched the children, their mothers would come fucking flying at you, they would claw your goddamn eyes out. So my brother, as the stupid man he is, goes up and tries to pick up one of these child baby monkeys. And you just, I was standing next to him and I see two monkeys flying at him. And one of them just beating him in his fucking leg and the other bites his pocket. And he...
He bit his pocket? Was he trying to go for his dick? What was happening?
No, like his side pocket, because that's where you usually have food. So I thought they were going for the food, but late till we found out he was actually trying to touch one of the baby monkeys.
Aww.
But the fucking monkeys, they flew at him, and I was like, what the fuck is going on? So I ran toward him and like chased the monkeys away, and then he's like, "You just runs off to my mom," and then I'm like, "Well, that was interesting," and then I go back like half an hour later, and it's like, "Well, your brother's off in the hospital. He's got bitten by a monkey," and I was like, "He got bit? Oh shit!" So he went, and then we went. They went to the hospital, and they found out that those monkeys all had rabies. And they were like, we've been playing with them, and they sat on your head, and one of them also pissed on my brother, and it's like...
Oh, lol.
And then we found all of them had fucking rabies. And we were like, oh, we all gonna wake up with, like, foam around our mouth now. So, what we found out is if you had an open wound, and you were around the monkeys, you'd get rabies. So, like, two more of us went and got those rabies shots.
Hold the phone! Why do they have open wounds? Who is walking around with open wounds around monkeys that are pissing on them? What is happening? What the hell are you doing?
It wasn't an open wound, but it was as long as it was bleeding. Like, one of the girls that we were with had scratched herself on some shell or something on the beach. And then we noticed that the monkey had her blood on him. So, like, she went and got a rabies shot.
What
but
the hell?
But those were fucking cheeky, because if you had food with you, like we found, like everyone, like they gave you bananas and that massage places, and they gave you nuts and fucking pineapple
all
over the place.
I bet they did.
So we brought that over there, and they like, you'd have 20 monkeys on top of you trying to steal you the food you had. And if you put it in your pocket, you'd be having monkeys that were like, the guys and man monkeys had like, 2 inches, 2 inches, I don't know, inches.
Yeah, monkeys.
Like 10 centimeters long, like really sharp teeth, and they'd like come at you and like hiss at you. Yeah, I was like, fuck it, you can have this pineapple, I don't even want it. Because they went fucking crazy.
Why were you just hanging out with monkeys? Why was your vacation
cute.
You and monkeys? Like,
they were cute.
They do not sound cute at all. They do not. They do not sound cute at all. Is that real? So, all right. So, you just went there to go, like, chill out? Or was... what? Why were you there?
It was a vacation. To chill out while it's being shitty cold in Norway.
I want to go to Thailand now. That sounds wonderful.
Really cool. It's everything's really cheap, and all the people are really nice. Like, you'd have... if you went to a restaurant, you'd have a waiter for your table. And then we just stand over there and wait for you to do something. It's fucking crazy.
I feel like if I were to go there, I'd get rabies from one of the massage girls.
Happy ending. You get a happy ending.
No, Jesse, you get locked in prison from one of the massage girls.
I just look. If that's what you consider kidnapping, I want an Asian hooker to kidnap me.
I heard about someone that got to Thailand and had a blowjob, and one of the hookers had drawn a knife on him and put it around his cock.
What?
Not a knife, scissor. A scissor. And put
What is this? Who? What?
What?
A guy that told me this.
This escalated really quickly.
They went to Thailand. One of the guys, because there was like a bunch of 18 and 19 years old, also went to Thailand.
Uh-huh.
And one of the hookers had dragged... a scissor on him when he got a blowjob from her.
And she was like, I'll cut you!
Yeah, basically. So I wasn't very... I didn't really... First off, I didn't want to get a blowjob or anything from the Thailand hookers, because then you get a surprise ending in the end. Second off, because I was with my family. And third off, because I didn't want my cock cut off.
Really?
Well, after my brother got bit, let's just say we weren't hanging with the monkeys anymore.
So what do you think of this wall?
I like the way this looks. I think the thing we need to do is first make the wall segment and stretch it from ocean to ocean, and then start just nailing in stuff every so many. To the Power Cove! Yaha! So, for this, I understand what I'm asking is kind of difficult to imagine.
The fuck?
So, this is what I am proposing for now. Little tiny boats, like, we'll stick a little tiny boat here, and little tiny boats, and they're, so these boats are all crashed together, but all the little tiny boats can be, like, chained to this thing.
Yeah.
And so we'll just put them all over the place. And the pagoda in the middle here, I feel like we can build around this. So, for example, there'll be another boat, like, I know diagonals are hard, so it'd be, like, maybe a boat on top of this boat, like, sprawled out over here, like, this direction. And then it's Jenga'd together with a boat that's over here and, like, is connected to this direction. And then that's Jenga'd together with a boat. Hopefully you guys know the game Jenga, so this makes sense.
Yeah.
And that's, like, put together with a boat that's up here. And then there's another boat that's over here that's up. And it keeps going up and up and up around this pagoda in the middle, and we can stylize
this.
What
I'm kind of thinking of, you know, like a funeral pyre, like a wood.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm thinking of. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
And
yeah.
So it goes up and around. Well, the reason, and that's the thing. The fate you would think it would fall over, but that's why we're going to build the outer pylons. And so what's going to happen is those four pylons that are going to hang above it that are giant metal ones. That's the new age stuff. Yeah, the Deep Space Nine rings. They're going to have chains connected to all of this. And it's going to be giant chains. And then at the top will be the docks for the airships. And so this is like the, I guess you could say like the boneyard of the old days when like ships were on the water. And so then they moved all the ships and made a fortress out of all the ships. And because now there are no water boats, everything is airships. Does that make sense?
Okay.
And so
yes.
all the boats that are now on the yeah it's obsolete technology, so rather than scrap it, they use it to create their new home. And so their home is all these boats, and what we're going to do is we'll stack all the boats up and around this center pagoda. We'll take the time to make this pagoda look freaking badass and make it so you can walk into it and so it looks cool. But then once all the boats are stacked, then we have to go through and carve out the inside of the halls to make it so you can move between all of them freely. But from the outside, it looks like they're all disconnected. But on the inside, it's like you can go through every single one of them. And I think that's the key.
Okay.
The key is going to be that, is making this look amazing from the outside, because it already does start to look very cool right now. And what we need to do is find new boat models and new things like that and add them to this, so we don't keep reusing boats.
Yeah, what we need is if anyone has any boats that they want to contribute,
go
to
the
medium
forum.
To large.
Yeah, go to shmoozy.com, go to the forums.
Bitch.
Yeah.
Back them on the forums.
Yeah. We need boats. All boats, 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 boats.
Boats, give them to me.
Yes. Yeah.
Other than that, I mean, I think that's how it will work, and we'll just stack them like you're right, like a funeral pyre. And stack it up, but it'll be big boats on the bottom, and then with little small boats maybe hooked up to it, because maybe there are some people like farmers or whoever. I don't know why farmers would be here, but there are people who still live in like little tiny, like those like in Thailand, the guy who lives in his boat still, that kind of thing, and they live around the outside.
Yeah.
And then big boats go up, and then as it gets towards the top, the boats get smaller and smaller, and then we have the rings around it, and then we can have docked airships up at the top. And
okay.
So we can even have docked, as it goes up, the little tiny boats that are in the water, we can also have docked little tiny boats, like Pinkbeard's ship can be like docked there, stuff like that. I think would be really creative. Does that make sense?
Alternatively, if you don't know how to make a schematic for it, build it on the Shibuzi server. Yeah.
That's
yeah.
a good idea.
Yeah.
Shibuzi.com,
VIP.
Thomas, you're gonna be my guy. I want you to just start freestyling, and then someone will mix this together. And go.
But I need someone to make a beat.
No, there's no beat. You just freestyle. Just go. Someone will make a beat.
I can't freestyle without a beat.
Someone just go. Thomas, just go. Just go. All right, here we go. Advertise like shameless whores.
Shibuzi.com. We got the stuff with the half a laugh. We got blocks. We got glowstone. Yo, ho, mo, fo, jo. We got the things that do upside down in the Minecraft. Yo, we got TeamSpeak. We got a website. We got it all. Yo, bro, ho, mo, fo.
Wow.
We go back. We go forward. We go up. We go down. We got the Minecraft in our back pocket from our granddad. Yo, bro.
That's it. That's it. That's it.
That was terrible.
That's it. Fuck, now to make that into internet gold.
I can't take it. Star?
We got it in the back pocket from our grandparents. Holy shit.
The worst thing was, he was walking around the ships, and as he was saying stuff, he was like, oh, and the glowstone.
Yeah.
GG. That is going to be amazing. Look, look, look. I feel like that might be a new end video. We need DJ Daniel Rothman remix to remix that.
We need talented people like this.
We need a guy who made the Shibuzi advertise like Seamus Horse to make advertise 2.0. All right, guys. That's it. Thank you for watching. And as always, to be continued. Advertise like Seamus Horse.
Just rapey. Anyway.